Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerful widescreen movie title. Before we begin, if you're not a subscriber to my channel, hit that small subscribe button at the lower right corner or in my video's description below. I provided a Photoshop template that you can download so you can follow along. Its link is in my video's description or project files. It includes three layers: storm clouds, a rock wall, and a frame that confines our movie title design to the 2.35 to 1 aspect ratio of widescreen cinemas. Click the eyeball icon next to the rock wall to temporarily hide the layer. Click the storm clouds layer to make it active. We'll place our text above it. Open your horizontal type tool and your list of fonts. I'm using a font called Optimus Princeps Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll make its size small enough to see temporarily, knowing that I'll be enlarging it once I type out my text. The anti-aliasing is sharp and center alignment. If the color box isn't white, click it, and when the color picker opens, pick white. Click on your document and type out your text. To enlarge it, highlight the entire line and place your cursor over the size icon and drag it to the right. To add a second line of text, click to the right of the last character and press Enter or Return to place your cursor below the top line and then type out your text. To adjust its size, repeat the steps. To raise or lower the second line, click the character paragraph icon to open the character panel, or go to Window and Character. Drag the baseline shift icon to the left or right to lower or raise the line. To adjust the space between two characters, click between those characters and press and hold Alt or Option and the left or right arrow key on your keyboard. To adjust the space between all of your characters, highlight the line and repeat the same keystrokes. To center your entire block of text, open your Move tool and press Ctrl or Command A to select your document. Click the Align Horizontal Centers icon and the Align Vertical Centers icon. Press Ctrl or Command D to deselect it. To raise or lower your text, press the up or down arrow key. We can close the character paragraph panels now. Double-click an empty area of the text layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel, the technique is chisel hard, and the depth is 400%. The direction is down, the size is 120 pixels, and soften it 0 pixels. The angle and the altitude are both 30 degrees, and the gloss contour is linear. The highlight and shadow modes are both normal, and their opacities are 100%. Next, we're going to blend our text into the clouds. Click Blending Options. We'll use the Blend If feature to achieve this. Let's move the layer style window to a corner so we can see as much of our text as possible while still seeing the Blend If section. Basically, Blend If uses luminosity to blend layers together. The slider bar that's labeled This Layer is the active layer, which is our text. The slider bar that's labeled Underlying Layer is the layer below the active layer, which is the clouds. In this case, we want the white pixels of the clouds to gradually cover our text, so we'll use the underlying layer to do this. The right slider controls the lightest luminosity of the clouds, while the left slider controls its darkest luminosity. Since we want to bring through the lightest areas of the clouds, drag the white underlying layer slider to the left. It essentially cuts off all the pixels from 255, which is pure white, to the point where we move the slider. To create a smooth transition, Alt-click or Option-click the middle of the icon. This splits the icon in half. Drag the left half to the left. The further you drag it, the smoother the transition. Feel free to play with the sliders to the amount of transition you like. Make the rock wall texture visible and active. We'll fill our text with this texture. To do this, make the texture into a clipping mask by pressing Alt-Control-G on Windows or Option-Command-G on a Mac, or by going to Layer and Create Clipping Mask. We'll make the darker areas of the texture stronger by clicking the adjustment layer icon and clicking Levels. Clip it to the text by repeating the hotkeys or by clicking the clipping mask icon. For the input shadow, type in 130. Lastly, we'll add a subtle blue-gray tint to our image. Click the adjustment layer icon again, and this time click Hue Saturation. Check Colorize. For the hue, type in 189, and for the saturation, type in 12. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.